It's a sellout. The seats in the back, can you hear me?
Yes.
Raise your hand in the very back if you can hear what I'm saying. Okay, is it clear?
Yes.
Let me explain why. The man who put this together is a wizard, a genius. Not only that, but he's famous. His name is David Gillette, and he invented the razor. Actually, that's not true if you knew it. Have you ever watched the Jim Lehrer News Hour before that McNeil Lehrer back in the day? He was the man who ran that program. He was the guy who wired the White House so they could have music programs. David, please stand up.
Discover that tonight.
He asked me a question and I'll pass it on. He He has a whole lot of cool early pictures of Port Aransas. Would you like to see those?
Yeah.
Jim? Come on up.
Well, I want to know how many people saw them last year. Who all was here to hear me last year? All right, we'll do them because nobody saw
them. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Jim Moloney.
You don't know how much of a thrill it is to one's ego when they have to put it for shares.
Maybe. If I can find the Port Aransas. Okay, last year I got really lucky. I've been collecting postcards for 25 years, and when Rick was talking about people outbidding you, I had Nemesis, who always outbid me. Unfortunately, he passed away about 5 years ago. Last year, I had the opportunity to spend some time with his daughter and essentially cherry pick his collection. Anything I didn't have, she let me buy. And so I got a whole bunch of Port Aransas cards that I scanned before I came over last year. You're going to get to see them again. These are them. The first one is of a ship docked at, I'm going to assume that's Harbor Island.
Yep.
Where we want to put a refinery in. I'm from Corpus Christi. Anyway, so there is a ship docked. Photograph is by Carl Swafford, who started taking photographs in the area 1914 or 1915, and continued to take them into the 40s, maybe the 50s. This was a postcard, and you can actually see it says that on Harbor Island Pier. And then the next one is a jumping tarpon. This actually looks like it was taken in the middle of the jetties, because that looks like a jetty behind you. So these are all random, they're not in any sequence. They're just the way I scanned them when I got them. And here is one, the opening of Corpus Christi Pass. Corpus Christi Pass is down separating Mustang Island from Padre Island. And in 1916, whoops, it actually was dredged and opened. This date is February 23rd, 1916. And that's another picture of it being opened, the same thing, opening of Corpus Christi Pass. It has been reopened, it's now called Packery Channel. Back then it was called Corpus Christi Pass. And you can see that's not a very wide opening. And then of course we had a hurricane in 1916, which opened it further, and then of course it silted back up. Here's some more. This is the Tugboat Grande at Port Aransas. Of course, that means Harbor Island. And the Husteca Grande at the docks of Aransas Harbor. Port Aransas. These are all Swafford postcards. Here's one of the dredge boat Comstock. And we had a good time with that, didn't we, Mark? Trying to figure out about the dredge boat Comstock.
There were two
dredge boat Comstocks. And the first one burned up around Galveston somewhere in around 1910. And this is obviously a later postcard. So the Corps of Engineers built a new dredge boat and named it Comstock also. There is the life saving station. I think that now is where the Coast Guard is. Is that correct?
That's right. Yes.
And here's a view of St. Joseph's Island. This is a Manhattan effect. country. It also was built in 1916. Menhaden. They are little fish like anchovies, and apparently they're what the tarpon used to feed on, or still do. And they built a factory on southern St. Joseph's Island, across from Aransas, Port Aransas, to process those things in early 1916, and it was wiped out by the 1916 hurricane. There's another view of the factory. And yet another. And this is a bird's eye view of Port Aransas in the distance from that Menhaden factory. So the little peaked building on the right-hand side is the Tarpon Inn, the old Tarpon Inn. Oh, I gotta find a cursor. Okay, yeah, I can put the cursor right there. That's the Tarpon Inn right there. And it's the old one before it was wiped out or burned down or whatever happened to it. The original. And here is a view. Mark, you want to talk about this one? This is a view.
I do want to talk about it, but the trouble is we can talk about it all day. There's a history mafia here in Port Aransas that are so bizarre that they go to incredible lengths to just identify what plant is in front of a house back in 1916 or something like that, because sometimes you can use that plant, that tree, that fence to be able to identify other things. And there are people that are crazy enough to want to do that. This showed up, and we all got mutinied because it's taken from the Tarpon Inn looking toward the Gulf. And if you look closely, and Jim removes that, you can see a tower or a cistern, and the location is right there we go, what's now the University of Texas. And the building that still exists, right up on the jetty, was a Corps of Engineers building that was built about 1895. That's in that picture. But when everything that you see here, you see a lumber yard, you see a dry goods store, you see the building on the right that's made out of block was a telephone exchange. All this stuff was being built because the town of Tarpon was so excited because it was going to become Port Aransas. And they named themselves after the port that was on Harbor Island, Port Aransas. And that was just opening in 1912. And so we never knew what existed. There were no surveys, like from insurance companies. And anyway, we can go on and on and on about this, but this gets your weak need if you're at one of the mafia in Port Aransas.
And I didn't know what I had. Those buildings, except I think for that one right there, and I guess the cistern's gone too, so just maybe that one is all that's left.
What building is that?
That's part of the university.
Oh, right, the university campus?
Yeah.
It's a dormitory.
And this was, this photograph was 1915, 1916, so it's before the 1919 hurricane wiped all that stuff away. It's what's exciting about old postcards is that they are historic documents, and a lot of people don't realize what we have here. So why won't that go? All right, we'll kill it. We'll go back. So that's Mrs. Burnett of Kentucky and her big tarp, Texas. John E. Cotter was the publisher and probably the photographer. That's a hand-colored postcard. They would take little watercolors and paint them. And here's one of a leatherback turtle caught at Tarpon. back in the old days, we used to keep them rather than protect them. And there's it in color, so they would do both. They would do both black and white and color. If you're a collector, you want those. And here is one of the steamer entering Aransas Pass. This is prior to 1907. And before 1907, your message had to be on the front of the card. Postal regulations. And here's a tarpon brought in to be mounted. Now, so there's what the tarpon guides used to wear. They used to be pretty well dressed in khakis and white, and wear a big broad hat. And notice how the guy is dressed. That's how gentlemen dress to fish, wearing a tie and a coat and a hat. And here we're building the jetties, the south jetty, and government office is right there. Okay, is that what that is? I buy the postcards, but I don't know what I'm buying.
So why were the jetties built then?
Do we have an expert here that knows about when the jetties were built?
This was about 1912. But we've had four iterations of jetties, and maybe next year we should have a presentation for our lecture series for building the jetties, because it's really so many fiascos, such bad engineering, good engineering, and we have a railroad in town, as you can see. And that building on the left still exists. That's out of the University of Texas. So just drive out there at the door. Take a look at it. And so they unloaded the rocks from a barge onto this dock, and then the rail cars were pushed out across the trestle, and then out to the end, you know, as the jetty was built, it got longer and longer and longer, and there was a railroad track on the jetties, and then they took it all apart as they came back, and they capped that with later on with granite that we see today.
Another one of the jetty being built. And there's the rail car right there.
Those big slabs of rocks, are those that were dumped?
These were already part of the jetty. So you see it's going out. They started at the shore and worked their way out. And then the morning catch a kingfish. Another one of the Coast Guard station. U.S. Life Saving Station. And then here's a postcard overlooking the harbor at Tarpon, Texas. And right there in the distance is the lighthouse. And then this one's highly, I don't know how long this pier lasted. There was a side pier that went from the jetties to the main pier, and on that pier was this tarpon fishing pier. And as far as I know, I've never seen any other pictures.
Nope.
What's the name of it,
Jim? I don't know. Somewhere around 1912, 15, before the 19, I mean, assume before the storm. That's a different building. Yeah. It might even be Rockport. Who knows? Up to the missed one. Oh, there's a receipt from the Aransas Harbor Terminal Railroad from 1912 that ran from Aransas Pass over to Harbor Island. Four cases of shoes, and they charged $1.30. the Border Grand's station where you waited for the boat, I think. Or that even may be a boat. Border Grand's is three round trips is what it says on top. Then the lighthouse, early picture of the lighthouse. Driving the first spike in advance of the terminal at Aransas Pass, Texas, 3-18-12. You think that was when they were going to start building the Aransas Pass Railroad?
I think it was after they had dredged the Aransas Channel, then they had a roadway there, and then they had just finished the track.
Yeah.
So probably 1912 or so.
Catch a redfish. Nice looking fish. Catch a Spanish mackerel. The revenue cutter Wyndham. And that actually may have been the boat that brought President Taft came to South Texas in 1909. It was his brother, his half-brother, owned the Taft Ranch. So he came down for a visit on that boat and it brought him into to Harbor Island. It may have brought him all the way to Corpus Christi. And among other things, he drove the first golf ball on the new golf course in Corpus Christi on North Beach, which was nine-hole golf course. And apparently, you know, President Taft was a fairly large man. And somebody snapped a picture of him bending over, putting his tea in. And that photograph was framed and put in the clubhouse of the... yeah, of the clubhouse for men. I assume it died in the 1919 hurricane because that was wiped out then. More pictures of somebody landed a tarpon on the jetties. There's the tarpon right there. It's hard to tell. Yeah, it's the size of a person. Port Aransas looking south. Again, here is the Tarpon Inn right here. And I don't know any of those other buildings. I guess that's the Coast Guard.
Right.
Coast Guard Life Saving Station. Of course, it doesn't, even the shoreline doesn't. Surf bathing. Those ladies probably had stockings on too. We weren't allowed to show anything other than a neck and a head. And that ended in 1918. What happened in 1918? The boys came back from Europe and brought those European fashions. The Nicaragua was beached actually down on Padre Island, just south of what's now the Pacari Channel. There's somebody posing with his fish. It does look like it's photoshopped, but it probably wasn't. I actually had a postcard like that. I was looking through postcards and on eBay, and somebody had said that this was one of those fake postcards. They didn't know that Tarpon got that thing. The quarantine station on Padre Island. Was that up here somewhere?
There was another one.
Tuberculosis, smallpox, yellow fever. If somebody came in on a boat and they were sick, everybody got stationed at the quarantine station for 2 weeks to a month until they were sure they were over the diseases. Some fish at Port Aransas. Those look like grouper. And here is the ferry landing. Had a store. As always, they had a line. Nothing has changed except the size of the cars.
That's from 1916. 34 Ford.
Here's a later picture of Porter Ranges. Another ferry line, it backed up all the way to the Tarpon Inn. This is the second Tarpon Inn. Probably 4th of July. I don't think they had spring break in those days. Here's another view. Look at that. Yeah, and this is what Port Aransas used to look like. Now it's covered with buildings. And yet another ferry picture. Looks like the same one. Yeah, here's the Tarpon Inn again. Yeah, this is the second one. And then a picture of the surf. This is about 1920s. Another picture of the Tarpon Inn. Barney's. Barney's Place, which became, I guess, Matthews. Started out at Matthews and became.
And its location is where Virginia's is today.
That's what we need, don't we? Current technology. So we need to book Port Aransas then and now. Some nice looking boats, and some not so nice looking boats. This is looking towards Harbor Island. There's three boats on Harbor Island over there. No, that's a, I don't see the lighthouse. That's a water tower there. And here's another view of Port Aransas. You can see it's starting to get more developed again. Here's the Tarpon Inn. That's either Barney's or Matthews. I don't know what the, we can blow it up. So now you can get an idea why I like postcards. Here's the old post office. Is it? Where is it? From here? Just right on this street?
Yes, right behind us to the north.
Okay.
Right next to the ice cream place. Across the deck where you had breakfast.
Another view of the business district. Wasn't very big in those days. And here's the boat basin. And here's where the ferry came in. See, there's only one ferry dock. Right there. Yeah, that's by the long line.
Is that called Robert's Point?
Anybody know what that's called? And here's another view, looking, I think, towards Harbor Island again. There's a kingfish, 43 pounds, 4 foot 6 inches long. What they were doing is they were taking postcard pictures so they could, anything that was, they thought would sell, so they thought the birds would sell. Obviously somebody bought it because I ended up with it. Here's a lady that's dwarfed by a pair of groupers. Who's a fisherman? How old are those fish? Anybody know? How many? So, 75 to 100 years old?
She doesn't look like that.
Minimum 50.